Good morning, evening, or afternoon, everybody. It's Kago coming at you with another video. So today we have some awesome more Phase 6 changes that are coming to us, and they have been absolutely killing it. I'm like actually surprised here, guys, because we got the announcement video and so many people were like, this is just like a raid, where's the content? And it was very different, like the announcement that they did with Phase 4 and Phase 5, like they showed us what we were getting, and this one they kind of like announced the timeline but didn't really tell us the meat and potatoes of the patch, which we're definitely getting now, which is freaking awesome. But before we get into the video, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Everything you guys do helps my channel grow, helps me get discovered, and helps me help as many people as possible, which is the entire point of my channel. So without further ado, let's get into the video. So I am here in Booty Bay on the PTR, just sort of messing around, finding things, and showing you the exact things that we need to look. So I'm over at the Tarnished Undermine Real Vendor. We're in Booty Bay, just outside of the Booty Bay Port Authority right here. And there are a few things I want to show. Also, the Looking for Group tool is available here on PTR. I'm not sure if they're going to like take this forward into SOD, but pretty cool. It has like it's like accurate too. Like it has Emerald Grove, AQ, Crystal Vale, Sunken Temple, Molten Core. Like it has the SOD stuff in it. So to me, that says it is designed with a purpose, which could be pretty cool to see this implemented. I don't really know if I've seen anything about that, so I just wanted to point that out and show you guys because I think it's really awesome. Then we are here at the Undermine Trader. As you can see, I don't see anything here changing. As of now, it is just the normal stuff that we have seen throughout the phases, and this is currently what it is on live. The Lost and Find Trainer still has the BFD pearls and stuff on it, but nothing else new to it that I know of. And then this one is the new trader. So this is Bubbles. She is a little gnome trader right here in the Old Port Authority. And Bubbles has some amazing items to look at and get for Tarnished Undermine Reels. So all of the toys that were in Gnomeregon as well as Sunken Temple are on this vendor. So you can get these toys and they will go into your keyring here. And as you see, I don't have any toys on this character. Whenever I copied it, it was a while ago, so he only has keys. But if you were to buy any of these, they would go there. Cosmetic items like the Radiant Ray Reflectors right here are there. Then we have some new exciting items. The Inanimator, which turns you into an inanimate object. A little tough to say there. And then we have a few other ones. So the Blood Ceremony. I'm not really sure what this does. Dagger engraved with a chant for an ancient Atoll Blood Ceremony. I wonder if this turns you into the Bloodlower or something. Then we have Censor of the False Prophet, which will let you perform an ancient Karaji ceremony. So that one turns you into Karaji. Ceremony. Then this one, Rod of Transformation, turns you into a Furbug. Rod of Dragons turns you into a Drachnoid from BWL. Then Rod of Bubbles turns you into a Naga. And then there is a Globe of Deception, which transforms the caster into a member of the opposing faction. And this turns Orb of Deception into a keyring item instead of a trinket. So you don't have to worry about trinket swapping, and you'll be able to keep it on for a while. And then the biggest one, and this is the coolest thing that I have seen, I haven't seen them really talk about this or post it anywhere, is the Bottomless Noggenfogger Elixir. So this has 1,000 charges, and I guess you can just spam drink it. You can have two of them at a time, and it takes 800 Noggenfogger Elixirs. So that is just an insane amount. That's like bag space cap. I do wonder, since some things have functioned this way, if you have the Noggenfoggers in your bank, if it'll let you pull it from this. I don't really know what works for that functionality and what hasn't, but there have been times where you can pull it from your bank and do that. I am not going to test it for you guys because I don't really use Noggenfoggers because I'm a druid, so they don't work, unfortunately. But it's pretty cool. Let me know what you guys think about that one. That is pretty awesome. But that's just all the stuff here at Booty Bay and in-game, let's switch it over to the articles to show you some new things that I can't really find here in-game for you. So this is transforming into some of the things. This is what they look like. So that's a Draconoid. This is the Furbog, and these are the Naga, which is really, really cool. These are just models and potential things that you can have. And this is a Karaji Prophet. So that is what the Prophet one does as well. So these are pretty cool, just fun. It'll be weird to see just people raiding as dragons and furbogs and nagas, but I think they've been a lot of fun inside, especially with the goblin one. The amount of times I get goblin during raid, it is ridiculous. But it is pretty fun and cool, and I like it a lot. Then we have void-touched weapons, which look sick. I honestly think this is the coolest effect that they've put in. Between Bloodied, Molten, and Shadow Flame, these look really, really cool. We don't know too much about them, what's going to drop, where they will drop, but here is just all of the graphics for them and what can be them, and they look pretty awesome. Not going to lie, I can't wait to hopefully get the dagger from Visidus and have that thing with Void Touch, because that'll look really, really cool. You know, maybe we'll find it in this list here at some point, but all in all, these look really awesome, and I can't wait to get them. And what's super interesting is that these can be Void Touch too, which is really weird to see the three-piece set pieces for classes be Void Touch. So I'm really curious about how those effects will translate into the game. But those are all the Void Touch weapons that we know of right now. Pretty awesome. They have that, like, they have a hue to them as well. They're not just the effect, like, they look brighter, and that's really cool. Then this is the world buff things, and so you can get the world buff things with Horde or Alliance combination signets. So you can get the Horn of the Dawn, which is Oni, which you can get that from Argent Dawn for 100 commendations. You can get the Songflower Seed from the Sonarian Circle for 100. You can get the Globe from Hydraxian Waterlords. You can get the Firewater Cauldron from Timbermaw Hold. The Spirit Conch from Zandalar, which gives the Zandalari tribe buff. And then we have, they're speculating the Rend is from Thorian Brotherhood, and the DMF 10% damage buff is from the Darkmoon Fair. But really cool to see these all appear, and you'll be able to get them for the accommodations, and it requires a neutral reputation in order to buy them from most of the vendors. So just keep that in mind, and it is a really good way to make the war effort be useful and not just a one-off open the gates, never touch it again, because they are making the war effort stay up the entire phase. So you'll be able to see, you know, exactly what you can turn in, and, you know, as GM, I'm probably just gonna end up doing 700 war effort turn-ins of whatever, getting all these accommodations, and then going to buy them all so I can make sure my raid can be fully world buffed the entire time. Gives me something to spend the guild bank on, that's for sure, because we've just been acquiring a ton of gold this entire time. Next we have the Sonarian Circle reputation rewards. Just, I've already covered these in the other video, but I wanted to further break it down for you guys so you understand. They're the new recipes, but as you can see, Wowhead did a really good job of breaking it down even further. So, like, blacksmithing is friendly to honored, and then revered for the Ironbind breastplate. Then we have friendly to honored to revered, and then exalted for the Dreamscale breastplate. And then with tailoring, we have friendly, honored, revered for the other stuff. So just wanted to briefly show you guys what it takes for Sonarian Circle rep and how you can get these new exciting patterns. As well as there's some cool new, I think this is probably the best thing that they've done. They've added new crafting materials, which is something we haven't seen in Classic, like, ever. And so Bolts of Karaji Silk, that's like greater than new, greater than rune cloth, but not like netherweave. So it's really, really awesome to see this stuff, as well as obsidian infused thorium bars are pretty cool as well. So the miners are going to be in there actually mining the bosses from AQ20 to get their obsidian, instead of just, you know, letting them rot after they've mined it for a bit. But all in all, really awesome changes. I'm super excited for Phase 6. Like, people were sleeping on Phase 6. They were surprised at all this information and just like, oh, we're just getting the raid, nothing else. Well, this sucks. But actually, they really have put in a lot of work and effort and time, and I can't wait for it to all go live. Right now, you can do the war effort and the Shifting Sands quest, but like not all of it is available, and I think it'll probably go available when the raid gets released on December 7th, I think is the date. So it'll be really cool. I can't wait to see it all. Let me know what you guys are thinking in the bottom down below. I look forward to reading it, and until next time, I'll see you later. Have a great day. Bye-bye.
Hey, you. Yes, you. Are you still there? Well, I appreciate you for taking the time to watch this entire video and making it to the end here. If you enjoyed this video, definitely check out the other videos about World of Warcraft listed in these playlists down below. And thank you again. Have a great day. Bye-bye.